Hello, I'm Dr. Gabriella Maffi, proud superintendent of Garden Grove Unified School District, where we are committed to treating all students as our own. As a mother of three, including a medically fragile child, I understand just how important it is that families know what to expect when campuses reopen for in-person instruction. We want all of our parents to trust that our schools are taking every precaution possible to create a safe learning environment for your children. We've taken our guidance from the California Department of Public Health and the Orange County Healthcare Agency and created very clear protocols to help minimize risk and keep our students safe. To our GGUSD staff members, we know that you are dedicated to keeping students safe, and you also want to feel safe and comfortable coming into work and adhering to new safety practices designed to slow the spread of COVID-19. Our Board of Education shares these concerns, and that's why we've created this video called A Day in the Life of a GGUSD Student to show our GGUSD community exactly what safety protocols to expect when returning to campus.
Since frequent hand washing helps prevent the spread of COVID-19, students should wash their hands each morning before heading off to school. Before leaving their house, parents have checked with each of their children to make sure they don't have any symptoms of COVID-19 and aren't running a temperature above 100.4. Parents must keep their children home from school if they are presenting COVID symptoms or running a temperature. After doing a quick symptom check, parents or students log the results in the easy-to-use daily health screening form on ParentSquare. This can be done from a computer or mobile phone. Schools will also have hard copies of the form available. All students are expected to wear face masks when entering their school campus. Their mask will be a part of their daily school supplies. Schools will provide all students with reusable cloth masks and lanyards to help prevent students from losing their mask. If a student forgets their mask, a disposable mask will be provided. Student temperatures will be checked upon entering the school bus and the school campus. School staff may take student temperatures throughout the day if necessary. Each school has designated drop-off procedures to ensure school entrances don't become too crowded. Throughout the school campus and inside the classrooms, there is signage promoting mask wearing, hand washing, physical distancing, and other healthy hygiene habits. Each classroom has been reconfigured with non-essential furniture removed to maximize space and provide for 6 feet of distance between desks. Classrooms have been outfitted with individual desk shields for extra protection. All teachers will have a plexiglass shield at their teacher workstation and will wear a mask and/or shield during instruction. Students will continue to wear masks while sitting at their desks in the classroom. Throughout the day, students will clean their hands using hand washing stations and touchless hand sanitizing stations on campus. In classrooms, students will either wash their hands with soap and water or use classroom hand sanitizer. While students will enjoy interactive instruction and will share many ideas with each other, they will not share classroom supplies like pencils, Chromebooks, or science equipment. Under current guidance, students in courses like band or choir will refrain from singing or playing wind instruments, but will continue to meet for instruction either indoors or outdoors. Students will also be expected to follow healthy hygiene practices like coughing into their sleeve, refraining from touching their face, and maintaining physical distancing. During lunchtime, grab-and-go meals will be available for those students who are taking their lunch home. These healthy meals are prepackaged and can be heated up from home. Some students who are remaining on campus for the full day, or supervised programs such as Boys and Girls Club, will eat lunch on campus and will receive hot meals served in takeout-style containers. All students will be expected to wash their hands before and after lunch. When schools reopen, the payment touchpad will be eliminated as all students will receive free meals. During recess or lunch breaks, or while outside for PE, students will maintain physical distancing. Students will keep their masks on in hallways and in bathrooms. In September, GGUSD athletes began outdoor practice and conditioning in a modified capacity aligned to national, state, and county guidelines. Currently, high school athletics is in phase 2, which limits gym and weight rooms to 10% capacity and requires 6 feet distancing for outdoor workouts. Each high school athlete completes a daily health form confirming he or she does not have any COVID symptoms prior to arriving on campus. Additional equipment has been purchased so that athletes can practice their sport without unnecessary sharing. Most extracurricular clubs, as well as one-on-one tutoring, will continue to host online meetings. Custodial staff have been trained on specialized COVID cleaning and disinfecting procedures and equipment that adhere to CDC guidelines. Throughout the day and after school, custodians will use high-powered, fast-acting airless spray sanitizers that disinfect with consistent coverage using EPA-approved disinfectants. This leading technology delivers the required atomization to wrap around surfaces and provide complete coverage, ensuring all school surfaces are cleaned effectively and thoroughly. Classrooms, gymnasiums, cafeterias, and other rooms will be sprayed daily or multiple times per day, depending on the school's hybrid model. Extra care will be given to high-touch point areas, including doorknobs, sink handles, counters, offices, and other common areas. If a student develops COVID symptoms while at school, he or she will be sent to the school's care room. The room will be isolated and staffed by an adult who will determine if the child truly has COVID symptoms and needs to be sent home immediately to quarantine. School nurses and health aides, as well as administrators and office staff, have been trained on CDC guidelines for responding to those who have tested positive for COVID-19, have symptoms, or have had close contact with a positive case. Some elementary schools will have a Boys and Girls Club program with on-site supervision and academic support to help families with young children. All school safety protocols will be implemented during any on-campus program. In addition to the health and safety protocols, schools will place a high priority on caring for students' social emotional well-being. All students have been impacted on an emotional level by the pandemic, and GGUSD schools will launch a Stay Strong initiative with social emotional learning embedded into the school day. GGUSD schools will also continue to offer school-based counseling and mental health support. There is nothing more important than the health and wellness of our GGUSD community. Thank you for doing your part to ensure a safe reopening of GGUSD schools.
From face masks to physical distancing, we must all do our part to create a safe school environment. The most important thing parents and staff can do is to keep up to date on school communication, as details may vary by site. Thank you for your patience during this unprecedented time in education. We trust that you will work alongside us to help keep our children and our community safe.